Till now we have seen data transfer group and arithmetic group. Now the next group is logical group. That are logical instructions. In logical instructions, operations that are logical in nature, for example, OR operation, AND, XOR, such type of instructions come in logical instructions. Let's look at the few examples. First, we see AND operation. Instruction is ANAR. R means register. With this operation, it means ANAR means the content of A will be logically ended with the content of register. Suppose A contains data 24, that is accumulator contains data 24, and register B contains data 02. Binary for A is equal to A will be 0010 and 0100. So the binary for 24 is this, and the binary for 02 is so. The binary for A is this, and the binary for B is this. So there will be AND operation between these two numbers. So the property of AND is multiplication. We multiply both these numbers and we write the result. So 0 into 0 equals to 0, 0 into 1, 0, 1 into 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So then accumulator will contain data 0, 00H. So now let's look at one more example. Suppose A contains data again 24 and B contains data 04. So now A will be 00100100, B will be 0000 and 0100. AND operation of this will be 00000. Here, because 1 into 1, 1, and this 00. The property of AND operation is that if both the numbers are same, means if both are 1, then only it will be 1, or else it will be 0. So here we get the number as, in accumulator there will be data will be 04. Similarly, now we done AND with register. Similarly we can do with memory location. ANAM. Here M is memory location that will be given in HL pair. So in this operation A will be A, this is symbol for AND, H and L. Similarly for ANI data, 8 bit, here also A will be A ended with data. Since we are done with AND instructions, let's see OR type of instructions. So for OR we have ORAR. R means register. The operation of this will be A will be A OR with register. Let's take an example. Again here suppose we have A equals to 24 and B equals to 04. So A will be like 00100100, and B will be 00000100. The property of OR of logical OR is like, even if any of the one contains 1, then it will be 1 or else it is 0. So this is 0, this is 0, there is 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0 and 0. So now the data will be 24. So now again accumulator contains data 2, 4. So in AND operation we follow the rules of multiplication. We multiply both these numbers and write the results accordingly. In OR we add the data. If suppose 1 plus 1, this will give, actually in binary it is 10, but here we write is 1. This is the property of OR. So in OR, if either of the data contains 1, then it give 1s or else it is 0. Similarly, now we saw for register. Next we can see as C for memory location. So for memory location it is ORAM. This will do A is equal to A OR with HL data. Or next ORI data 8 bit. A will be A OR with 8 bit data. Next we have exclusive OR type of instruction. Let's see what is exclusive OR. XRAR. R is register. What this will do? A will be exclusively ORed with the data of register. So A will be A ORed with data of register. Let's look at its example. Again, say the data of A is equal to 24 and data of B is 04. So A will become 00100100 and B will be 00000100. Property of XOR is, if both are same then it is 0 and if both are different then it is 1. So this is the easy way to remember. Whenever you see both are 0 then it is 0, and if both are 1 then also it is 0, and if both are different then it is 1. So both are same, 0 0 0 0 0, same means this is not same, this is different, it is 0 and 1. So this will be 1, this is 0 and this is also 0. So we have the data in an accumulator, the data will be 2 0. Now we saw this for register. Similarly we also have for memory location, like we had in OR and AND instructions. For memory location instruction is XRAM. This will do A will be A exclusively ORed with data of HL memory pair and XRI data 8 bit. This will also give A will be A XORed with data 8 bit. Next thing we have in logical instructions is comparing. Let's see CMPR. R means register. This instruction will compare the data of this register with the accumulator. How does it actually subtract the data of register with accumulator? It does this A minus R, but A does not, is not affected. Whatever the data is in A will remain same. This just does internally in the microprocessor to check if what is the relation, if it is greater, less or small. Things that you need to remember is the effect of this instruction on the flags. In this, if the data of A is equal to R, then 0 flag is set to 1, and if A is less than the data of R, then carry is set to 1, and if A is greater than R, then both 0 flag and carry flag are 0. Similarly, here we saw CMP R. We also have instruction CMP M. M means memory location. The instruction is same like this, so I hope I don't need to explain it again. Similarly, we have also CPI data 8-bit. It does the same like this, except here we had register, here we have data, and here we have memory location. Next thing we will see is this instruction RLC. This instruction is also the part of logical instruction. What happens with this instruction is it rotates the content of accumulator. What this means, let me show you. Suppose accumulator has 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 1. Suppose this is the data in accumulator. This is 8-bit data present in accumulator. So after the execution of this instruction, what exactly will happen is, this is carry flag. This has some data, suppose here it is 0. And this is accumulator. Again, we will copy the data 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 1. So this means rotate the content of accumulator left. For me, left is this. So what this will do, this will rotate the data by 1-bit left. So after the execution of this instruction, what we will have is the data will be shifted from here to here. This data will go here, this here, all will be shifted with 1-bit. The thing you need to remember is this data will go here and this data will also go here. So this means this will be copied here also, and this will be copied here also. Next is RRC. This is similar, just for this part. Here it was left, here it will be right. It will rotate content of accumulator right. So suppose same A is having the data 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 1, and here carry has 0. After execution of this instruction, what will happen? This one will go here and this one will go here. So we can see this will go here as well as here, and this data will go here, this at this place, and same. both these are same, this goes in left direction and this in right. And you need to remember, this data will be copied here and also here. For better we can give it a mark. Suppose this data is A0, this is A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6 and this is A7. So the point you need to remember is A0 will get the data of A7 and also carry will have the data of A7. Here A7 will have the data of A0 and carry will have the data of A0. Instruction that we have is RAL. This also does the same like we saw in the above example where we had RLC, except the fact that this rotates the content left through carry. Rotate accumulator left through carry. What this means is, in above example we had, suppose we have the accumulator data 0101010 4 5 6 7 8, okay, this is 8 bit data. And now suppose carry flag has the data 1 and this is also again the data of this accumulator 0101010, this is accumulator. So with RAL the data of each bit will be shifted left with one bit. But the thing is, here this will go like disk. So this 0 will go here, this 1 will go here, this 0 here, this 1 here. So it will be like this. This goes to carry, the data of carry will go here and so on. This is the flow of the data. So let's mark. So after the execution of this instruction, the data we will have is this. This is carry flag. So this 0 will come here. This 0 will go to carry flag. This 1 will go here. This 1 will go here. This 0 here. This 1 here. This 0 here. This 1 here. This one will come here and this 0 here. So I hope now you understand what is the difference between RLC and RAL. Similarly, we also have this instruction for write. RAL, we also have instruction RAR. This will rotate accumulator right through carry. Sorry. Back here again. Here what you need to remember is, the data of A7 will go into carry and the data of A0 will go to carry. So carry will have the data A0. Now coming back here again, accumulator has data 0101010 and carry has 0. So after, so as I was saying, in this the data flowed in left direction, here it will go in right direction. By right I mean this 0 will be copied in carry, this one will go here, this one here, this 0 here and so on. So this will go here, this here and likewise. So here what you need to remember is the data of A7 goes into carry and the data of carry goes into A0. We will write this as carry has the data of A7 and A0 the data of carry. Sorry, I need to make one correction here. Here this will be opposite. A7 will get the data of carry. Next instruction that we will see is complement accumulator, which is CMA. It means complement accumulator. What this instruction does is, suppose A has the data 0101010101. Suppose A has the data 0101010101. After the execution of this instruction, this data will be complemented. The meaning of complement is wherever we have 0, it will become 1, and wherever we have 1, it will become 0. Suppose, therefore, after execution of this CMA, we will have the data 10101010. Next that we have is complement carry. We write this as CMC. It means CM complement carry. Please note that this instruction is only of 1 byte because there is no extra data or memory location given here. In the language, we only write CMA or CMC. CMC means complement carry. Suppose if carry flag has data 0, after execution of this instruction, carry will have the data 1. Simple. Next we have STC. This means set carry. What this instruction does is, this will turn the data of carry flag into 1. If it is 0, then it will make it 1, and if it was, and if it is 1, then it will not do anything. Example, if CY is equals to 0, after execution of this, CY will become 1, and if CY has data 1, then CY will remain 1.